Hello and welcome to St. David's Church. Today is the fourth Sunday in Advent. So today we light the candle that symbolises love. What forms of love do we mean? Mary's love for the child she was carrying, God's love for us, but also our love for this tiny baby of pure love. This love sent from heaven who would become our Lord and Saviour. We know we have a week to go until Christmas, but we couldn't resist the Wren Collective with their version of Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee.
Joyful, joyful, we adore Thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before Thee, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. Joyful, joyful, we adore Thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before Thee, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. Rejoice, rejoice, our God is here with us. Emmanuel, our God is still with us. All Thy works with joy surround me. Stars and angels sing around Thee, center of unbroken praise. Ever singing march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music leads us onward in the triumph song.
The Collect for today. Eternal God, as Mary waited for the birth of your Son, so we wait for his coming in glory. Bring us through the birth pangs of this present age to see, with her, our great salvation. Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Meinwin will now read today's Gospel.
This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to the public disgrace, he had in his mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are able to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophets. "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name of Jesus.
What a scandal! Nice girl Mary engaged Joseph and then suddenly pregnant. And Joseph's not the father. Joseph, quite rightly some would say, has decided to dismiss Mary quietly. He will send her away, not for her to be completely shamed. After all, he still has feelings for her. They can go their separate ways and get on with their lives. Isn't that what most people would do? This story about carrying God's son is a bit, well, far-fetched. Unbelievable? So every fibre of his being says, turn away from the situation. Joseph knows better than to believe Mary's fantastic story. Joseph knows what he believes, and he believes what he knows. And that is the problem. The way he thinks is too small, too narrow, too limited, with no wiggle room. I suspect there are times when we are all a lot like Joseph. How often have we dismissed people, ideas, dreams, or opportunities simply because we don't understand them? Or they don't make sense? Sometimes we just refuse to open ourselves to something new. But sometimes we refuse to open ourselves to God. That's what Joseph's doing. When he decides he wants to dismiss Mary, he's dismissing God with us. He's dismissing not just Mary, but the mother of God. The one, the very one who will give God human flesh. A body here with us on earth. Ultimately, Joseph took Mary, his wife. It took a visit from an angel to help him move beyond what he understood, to open himself to the possibility that God would choose a girl like Mary and a man like himself to be parents to Emmanuel, God with us. In our next worship song, we look at some of the questions Joseph may have asked in a strange way to save the world.
I'm sure he must have been surprised where this road had taken him, 'cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from the angel. Just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Why here inside this stable filled with hay? Why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. To think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved, there would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly shepherds at his birth. A
But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far. And as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Why here inside this stable filled with hay? Why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not a one to second guess what angels have to say. Such a strange way to save the world. Oh, 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 oh. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say. Is such a strange way to save the world. This is such a strange way. Such a strange way. A strange way to save the world. Oh, oh,
Matthew's Gospel doesn't tell us whether Mary and Joseph talked things through, as we would today. After all, there would be lots to talk about. Yes, there is the scandalous element to this story, but maybe more than a virgin birth. The real shocker is that God, through Mary, has taken on flesh and blood and comes to us. That means that God is with his people in a completely real way. God is with us in all the situations that make up our lives. In the joy and sorrow, in our success and failure, in our hopes and fears, God is with us. If we try to rationalise this amazing miracle, we lose so much. We lose the wonder, the supernatural. We miss out the faith that this truth is beyond our understanding, but still happened. So here's the thing. All of us are somewhere on the Joseph spectrum. Some of us would have dismissed Mary, while some of us would have trusted her. Through him, we can see our dismissive self and also our accepting self. So let's not look for answers. Let's think what might be born in us, what needs to be born in us, what's waiting to be born in us. That's how we open ourselves to life with all the possibilities. That's what Joseph did, and Mary, and all the generations since then. After all, it's the scandal we've been waiting for. Our next worship song is the haunting Mary, Did You Know? So, just relax. Forget about all you need to do in this last week before Christmas. Take some time out to breathe and to think about the Christmas miracle.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters?
Did you know that your baby boy
has come to make you new. His child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand?
Did you know?
There can be no better time to make things right with God than this week, when our eyes are firmly fixed on the celebrations of our Lord's birth. Join with us now in the words of the confession. Almighty and merciful God, we have sinned against you in thought, word and deed. We have not loved you with all our heart, and we've not loved others as Christ loves us. We are truly sorry. In your mercy, forgive us. Help us to amend our lives that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
May God our Father, who by our Lord Jesus Christ has reconciled the world to himself and forgives the sins of all who truly repent, pardon and deliver us from all our sins and grant us the grace and power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's say the baptismal creed together.
I believe and trust in God the Father, who created all that is. I believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ, who redeemed mankind. I believe and trust in his Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God. I believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Now join us in prayer today.
Everlasting God, we come today on the last Sunday of our Advent journey towards Christmas, and we give thanks. We remember those journeys that were being taken on that first Christmas 2,000 years ago. Mary and Joseph, travelling by foot to enroll in the Roman census. The wise men, following the signs in the heaven. The unsuspecting shepherds, moving from pasture to pasture with their flocks. The Jewish nation, also unsuspecting, moving through history towards a world-changing event. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, as we think of Mary, pregnant with the Holy Child, journeying towards motherhood, we pray for all women who are expecting a new addition to their families. We also remember that not all pregnancies are wanted, and so pray for all those who are carrying unwanted babies and for decisions they have to make, some which may be very unpleasant. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful God, we pray for all who, like Mary and Joseph, are making long and difficult journeys by foot, especially those fleeing from war and terror. We pray for all those in the Ukraine who are now still, after all these long months, facing war and hardship, drought, famine and persecution. For all those embarking on perilous journeys across the seas in dreadfully unsuitable craft, and for those who are providing rescue services. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, Lord, we pray for those in our own communities who are struggling with different types of needs, poverty, bereavement, illness. We especially pray for children and adults everywhere, some who have never heard of you and think Christmas means Father Christmas. Help others, teach them the true meaning of Christmas, the birth of your dear Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Let us now say together the glorious prayer Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Grace and peace be with you, and keep you in the love of Christ. Father of glory, holy and eternal, look upon us now in power and mercy. May your strength overcome our weakness, your radiance transform our blindness, and your spirit draw us to that love shown and offered to us by your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
This Wednesday, we continue our journey through Advent with the Crib Story, which you can watch on our YouTube channel during the evening. Our on-site services over Christmas will be coming up on the screen now. On Christmas Day, our YouTube service will be a little different than usual. Well, in fact, it'll be a lot different than usual, with some unexpected guests. Drop in and watch it when you can. Thanks to all who's helped with today's service and to the members of our on-site congregation who have helped with our Advent short films.
We need to say a big thank you to you, our virtual parish, for supporting us in 2022. Please, if you have the time next week, let us know about your Christmas and share some stories if you'd like to. Let's say the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Our last worship song for today is by Anne Wilson and is called I Still Believe in Christmas.
You are all in our prayers.
Goodbye.
The choir singing carols, bells are ringing, streets are bright. It's Christmas all around me, so why is Christmas hard to find? December snow is falling down like I am to my knees. I could use some hope right now, cause right now hope is hard to see. Help me still believe. Down. I still